song we'd like to start with tonight is a song called Walking in the Night. It comes from a verse in John 11, I think it's verse 10, where Jesus is on his way to Judea. The Pharisees come up and start talking to him, and they tell him, you know, you're crazy to go to Judea because people there are trying to kill you. But he said, those that walk in the night stumble and fall, but those that walk in the daylight don't have to worry about that kind of thing because they can see where they're going. And Jesus walked in the light, and when we have Jesus, we walk in the light as well. This song's about someone who is walking in the darkness, walking in the night. Larry says he has to make an adjustment here for a second. Second song that we'd like to do is called Oh Holy Spirit. I think just the real importance that we might really add here while Larry's figuring out there is that, what can I use for an example? A tree, okay? There's just no way that a tree can survive without the sap running through it. If the sap didn't run through a tree, for that life wasn't going through that tree day after day, the tree would die. It's just as simple as that. It's the same with us as Christians. If we as Christians don't have the Holy Spirit flowing through us every day, as Christians, we're going to die. There's going to be no life flowing through us. The Holy Spirit is the life of Jesus. And that's
what we're here to sing about tonight, to tell you about the Lord, allow you to know that he's real and practical and he's alive today, and that his spirit is here to fill us and to allow us to be used by him. Larry's written a song called O Holy Spirit. Kept Americans under the power of the devil for a long time is that we feel that because we were born in America, land of the free and home of the brave, being a Christian nation, that we're all Christians automatically. And that's not true. In order to be a Christian, you have to recognize yourself as a sinner, recognize Jesus as the Savior of the world, and accept that. Accept him into your life. Name of the song is How Long Has It Been? And I would just really appreciate if everyone here would just ask themselves the questions that come up in this song. It's not going to do anybody any good if you try to kid yourself throughout your whole life concerning these questions. But if you answer them honestly, you may see yourself in a different light. It's called How Long Has It Been?
Jesus, that you love him.
do you pray? When you meet with him each day, just to tell him that you care. Forgive me for the things that I've done. Your Son and your Spirit's love, and I give my life to you. How long has it been since you've asked Jesus in? How much have you grown since then? In how many ways do you give our Father your praise in these mixed up and troubled days? Forgive me for the wrong that I've said. Jesus, you're the bread of life to me, and I'll never hunger again. No, I'll never hunger again. This next song is Jim's song. Kind of an old 50-ish type tune. Listen to the words, they're important, okay?
Just count on me.
Just count on me.
Just
This is a song that comes from the fourth chapter of John. It's called He Gave Us a Well, and it's kind of written about the conversation between Jesus and the woman at the well. And Jesus said that, you know, you can drink from this well all you want to, and you're going to thirst again. But I know where there's a well that never runs dry, that keeps bubbling up unto eternal life. And that well is in the Holy Spirit, which we receive when we receive Jesus Christ as our Savior. He gives us all the peace and the joy that we could ever want or ever dream of. And it just keeps bubbling up inside of you, just forever. He gave us a well that'll never run dry.
He said it never, let me be lonely, just trust in him only and believe what he said. Wherever I am, he's right beside me, from enemies hides me through the valley of death.
Favorite songs that we're going to do tonight because of the promise in it. When the Lord came down to earth and died, rose again, and after he ascended back into heaven, he didn't leave us up the creek. He didn't leave us high and dry. He gave us his Spirit to be with us. And I know a lot of you aren't going to understand that, but a lot of you are. One of the reasons we're here tonight is to set the challenge before you and allow you to make a decision. Everybody here is going to have to make a decision sometime or other tonight about what road you're going to choose, about which way you're going to walk. The person sitting next to you tonight could spend eternity in hell. Did you know that? Think about it, okay?
Some sharp and jagged rock. Well, I wouldn't want to fall. But now the devil wants to throw me down. He wants me shattered on the rocks below. He wants to steal my prize away from me. He wants me shattered on the rocks below. But the one who holds me in his arms won't ever let me go. Yeah, he brought me up here to be with him, and he's not about to let me go. Oh no, he's not about to let me fall. And it feels like the sunrise in the morning, and it stays with me all of the day. And by nighttime I can rest in his flavoring.
On our little gimmicks going crazy and out of tune.
Larry
strength.
Likes his toys.
Never grew out of that.
We're going to do a quiet song right now, and I'd appreciate it if you'd listen. This song comes from a picture that hangs over my desk at home. It's a picture of a ship out in the sea. It's being just torn apart by the waves and the storm around it. There's a pilot standing at the wheel, and right behind him there's Jesus, and he's got his hand on the wheel too. And we believe that Jesus Christ came to this earth to pilot you and to pilot me, that he doesn't want you to have to live your own life. He knows what a frustrating, frightening experience that is, to realize that the only person that can control and run your life is yourself, because you know how inadequate you are. I know how inadequate I am to run my own life. But he has come to pilot thee.
The storm, and I am lost upon this ship at sea, and soon will come the waves. Is there anybody here to comfort me? Oh, don't be through, just give him command. the night, and I see no beacon to guide me to the shore. And I can hear the waves crashing on the rocks which lie before. Oh, don't be afraid, for it's in His hand, and He'll lead you through. Just give Him command, for He has come to pilot thee, to steer your vessel for eternity. He rules the world, but cannot rule in your life. He rules the world, but cannot rule. Until you leave the throne.
Because the three of us have given our lives to the Lord, He's our master. Your Lord. Well, then I'm sorry to say, but you're a slave to sin. Open up your heart and ask Him in. He'll be your master. He'll be your master.
About a 15-minute break.
hope to see you all when we come back, okay? Thank you.
We'd like to share with you now our acoustical set, and I think we maybe have ironed out a few of our problems and loudness and so forth. These things happen, and we thank the people for letting us know when the words aren't coming through and when the guitars are too loud and so forth. We'd like to share with you now a song, and if you think about the sweet bird being the Holy Spirit in the song, I think you'll understand what we're trying to say.
Sing to me, sweet bird, sing so that I'll understand. Whisper it to me, wings in the night of the land. And course me a map and map a course to see. Send me a singer to follow a road that is free. And when it is done, I'll be thankful, and you
One of the neatest things that the Lord has done for us, and we probably don't even realize it in a lot of ways, is given us our memory. I think a lot of us can remember, if we've just accepted the Lord recently, to what we were like before we knew Jesus, before we were walking with him. Us as a group, we come from just a general all-around nice guy to a rock and roll background to a drug background. But yet, we're not here to pour out a personal testimony on you. We're just here to tell you that sin is rebellion against God. So whether you're a junkie down on Hennepin Avenue, a prostitute on Hennepin Avenue, or just a really sweet, nice kid who goes to Jefferson High School, if you're serving yourself, you're in rebellion with God, and it's sin. And that's what Jesus came to die for. But this is a song called Jesus, You Changed My Life. And I was going to say something else, but maybe I shouldn't. Okay, Jesus, You Changed My Life.
Jesus, You changed my life all around. You took me from the sand and put my feet on solid ground. And I thank You, Lord. I thank You, Lord, for giving new life to me. From a slave of sin, You set me free. Used to love to do, You made them all become old, and You gave me something new. And I thank You, Lord. I thank You, Lord, for giving new life to me. From a slave of sin, You set me free.
This song is a song I think that's meant a lot to us as a group, because we found the only person that we would really want to follow and the only person we enjoy following in life is Jesus Christ. And this song is called Only, Only, I Only Want to Follow Jesus.
Savior spoke to me. My burden's lighter, you will see. Just take up your cross and follow me. As you allow me, I will lead. I'll show you life you've never seen, and teach you just how easy it is to be.
Favorite song in terms of what the words mean to me and what I'd like them to mean to you. It's called Rise Up, and I think that's what we all need to do, rise up unto the Lord in our everyday lives and everything we do.
Then the kings and the people will see that you are the died on the tree, and then they'll know that you rose again, all in line with the Father's plan. Then your people will shout and sing, glory be to the King of Kings. We'll stand before you and we'll praise your name, glory be to the King today.
Rise up, rise up, rise up.
Many people will bow their heads and look at you and feel sad, 'cause they'll remember that they turned away and tears will come down on that day. But your people will shout and sing, glory be to the King of Kings. We'll stand before you and we'll praise your name. Glory be to the King today. Rise up, rise up, rise up unto the Lamb. Rise up, rise up.
Given us these songs as we've gone through different phases of life and different steps in our own spiritual lives. This is a song called When You Were Young. I think in order to get the real meaning of the song, you have to do two things. You have to think back to when you were young and kind of walk down memory lane along with the song. But the second and most important thing is try to see the meaning with your spiritual eyes, okay? When you were young.
Hey, look, Dad.